Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to episode 4. We got a nice, beautiful Riverwood morning here. What's that?
Yep.
And you'll take care of it?
Don't I always?
I don't suppose I could convince you to take care of it now, could I?
No.
I should have guessed.
You guys stop bickering, I swear. You have a guest. I'm a patron at this inn. You gotta put on your best business face, my friend. Anyway.
Rooms and food.
Yeah, I know that. I actually don't need either. It's okay, thanks, Orgnar. Anyway, welcome back to this episode, this beautiful Riverwood morning. There's a couple things that I want to talk to you guys about, so I figured we'd take a step outside, see what's going on, maybe hop across the river and have a nice little chat. I need to drink from the river, too, because, you know, I'm thirsty, naturally. And we'll have some apples. It's gonna be a good time, I think. So the first thing I want to talk to you guys about, as some of you may have noticed, is the title is different for this episode, and I've gone back and changed the titles on all the other Requiem Reborn materials as well. And there's a reason for that. And the reason is, basically what happened was the Requiem team reached out to me and told me that they've been getting some kind of confused users reporting that they weren't super sure exactly what Requiem Reborn was. They didn't know if it was like a video series or a mod that was designed to supplant Requiem, which obviously is not the case, and they requested that I change the name just to kind of, you know, make things a little bit less confusing for everyone, and obviously that's no problem, and we're still so early on in the series that it was no trouble at all to go ahead and change that. And the last thing that I would want to do is create more work for the Requiem team, because if you guys know the Requiem team, they're probably one of the hardest working teams in Skyrim modding, and the sheer extent that Requiem covers, the amount of work that it took to create Requiem is both inspiring and terrifying. So the last thing that I would want to do is create more work for them. That's where we are now on that. The second thing that I want to talk to you guys about, which I'm actually super excited about, is our character and our little crowdsourced backstory. So in the last episode, I asked you guys if you had any input on, you know, who our character was and what direction we should take her in and where she'd been and all that stuff. And I think now we have a very strong thematic direction for our character. And here's what I think we're going to do. I think we are going to turn her into a fairly standard, you know, holy warrior, crusader, paladin type, at least for now. And to fill out a little bit more of her backstory, here's what we got. So she's not from Skyrim. She's from another province. We don't know exactly where. It can really be any one of them. It doesn't matter. We can have some fun with that if we'd like. She's not from Skyrim. And very recently, wherever she's from, she experienced a death of a loved one, of a close person to her. It could have been a family member. It could have been a friend. It could have been a lover. Really, whatever we want to do with it. But so she experienced this death. And shortly thereafter, she started having these dreams. Just, you know, kind of an amorphous figure. It's kind of unclear. But in these dreams, she felt this compulsion to go back to Skyrim. I shouldn't say go back. She's never really been there before. But to go to Skyrim, to go to her fatherland, the fatherland. She is a Nord, and she's never been there before. Anyway, these dreams keep getting stronger and stronger until she feels the need to go to Skyrim, to stop whatever she does, which we also don't know. Whatever she does as an occupation, we can have fun with that as well. I think it would make the most sense if it's something fairly martial, something involving fighting or maybe weapons training, because she takes a job as a merchant escort, as a bodyguard, as we saw, on a ship in order to get to Skyrim. But anyway, she goes in the ship, and she, you know, makes her voyage over to Skyrim, and one night, as she's asleep, she's visited by that figure in her dream again, and this time it's more clear than ever, and this figure tells her that, you know, kind of, this is your moment of awakening. This is when your life truly begins, and this is when the true trials of your life will start. And wouldn't you know, right as she wakes up from that dream is when the ship begins to crash, is when the ship becomes shipwrecked. And what we know and what she does not know at this point is that the figure speaking to her in her dreams is RK, who is one of the divine in charge of kind of death and life, I believe. Also maybe the law, or maybe that's Julianos. I'm not super sure, but I know he's kind of the purveyor of like death. And what she's going to kind of do is become a champion for the divines, for RK, against, you know, all the evil, nasty things like undead and the dark corners of the world, which I think is going to be a really fun direction to take with the character. That gives us a lot of freedom in terms of what we can do and what we can pursue. We can try and become a champion of RK and, you know, make do with all the benefits and bonuses that come with that and challenges. We can do a couple quest lines like Undeath and Dawnguard, which will take us, you know, up against undead and other dark, scary things. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I also think that it's going to be a major challenge, because as some of you guys know, in Requiem, undead creatures like vampires and draugr are among the toughest things that you can fight. So I think it'll be a lot of fun. But, of course, before we get ahead of ourselves, we have to survive long enough to make it to all those factions and quests and fun things for us to do. So that's what we're going to focus on now. What I really want to do is... Oh, that's what I need to do first. Is I want to fuck around with some bandits. Because right now, we have no starter gear. We are a scrub and a half. So we're going to fix that. We're going to get some shit done in this episode and have some fun. Also, can we just take a second to look at how beautiful Riverwood is? I love this place so much. It's one of my favorite little cities. Anyway, first thing we gotta do is get some nice food in us. Got some sweet roll, got some apples. Go ahead and go to the river here and take a quick drink. We don't really have any gold, we can't buy any food. It would be really nice if we had like some stews, but we don't. So we're really gonna have to be careful about how we manage our stamina. The thing that I wanted to get, and I'm hoping we can pick up a fairly cheap one from the trader here, is a torch. And the reason that I want a torch shouldn't be very hard to come by. I'm sure we'll find one
of us has to
in one way, shape, or form.
I said no. No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
Whatever.
Yeah, I don't know what you...
They're arguing about how a thief came in and stole the golden claw and went to Bleak Falls Barrow. You guys have probably seen that whole thing before. Okay, let's see. You gotta have a torch. No torch. Awesome. So sick. Okay, well, the reason that I wanted a torch is because... wait, do I have a torch? Did I pick one up in the ship, maybe? Oh, I do! Alright, sweet. Perfect. That works out perfectly. So the reason I wanted this torch is this area outside of Riverwood, where I'm going right now, is Ember Shard Mine. I definitely will not be able to clear the mine. Not anywhere close, really. Oh, and do I have... No, I don't have any ore. That was the last character. Anyway, I'm not going to be able to clear the mine. I'm not even going to attempt to clear the mine. I'm just going to kill the bandit that's out front and just kind of maybe get some wolf pelts. But what I was about to say is that this area is packed full of wolves, which I'm sure there's a pun in there about wolves and wolf packs, but I'm not great at puns. But there are wolves all over the place here, which is very dangerous because all we have is this little teensy dagger and clothes. We have literally no armor. Sorry, we have a leather helmet. So we're going to try and protect ourselves from these wolves with our torch, because wolves are afraid of torches, as you will see in a moment. So we got to be really careful. Now, you guys might have noticed this with Autumn, but there's no music playing in Ultimate Skyrim. And the reason for that is because we need literally every advantage we can get when it comes to detecting threats. Oops, sorry, I keep accidentally clicking. But we need every advantage we can get when it comes to detecting threats. We can use this to listen in. Doesn't seem like there's any wolves nearby. I know they're around here somewhere, though. So we're gonna have to be very careful. Because if something gets the drop on us, we are in serious trouble. Okay, there's a wolf. Shit. It'd be really nice if we don't have any, what's it called? Marksmanship training. But it would be really nice if we could get, like, a drop on one of these wolves with an arrow. What do we need? We need hide lace and firewood, and we can only get that stuff by hunting these wolves. So here's what we're gonna do. We don't have any sneak experience too, so this might end very badly. Be ready to run back to the town if we need the help. In fact, that might be the safest thing to do. Hey! Oh. Oh, he sees me. He doesn't want to attack yet though. I think he's by himself. Yeah, so you can see, this is our survival instincts. And we can see when they make sound. Anything that makes a sound will show up like that. It's pretty useful. All right, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna kite this boy. Let's make sure we get our torch ready. In fact, I'm gonna assign that to 2. So we get 2. Oh, here it comes. Yeah, all right. So they're afraid of fire. They really don't like that. Where did he go? Where'd that wolf boy go? Oh, here he is. All right, so he should try to stay away from us. If we can catch up to him. Ah! Ah! Almost. We're gonna waste a bunch of stamina doing that. Where'd he go? I missed him. I lost him. Those wolves are so fast. Is he down here? Oh, he is. Oh my god. Whoa! He went across that river so quickly. Oh, I really want those pelts. Take some mountain flowers, too. Where'd he go? He's up there. Oh, there's an elk, too. We really need that wooden longbow. We just need to take down one of these fucking guys. And we'll have enough. Right, here we go. We got wet right there, but that's okay. We're in an area of the world where the weather is not particularly terrible. Man. Oh, I heard him. He's still scared. Maybe I'll get rid of my torch and that might trick him into coming back at me. Oh, yep, here he comes. Here he comes. All right. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Here he comes. Oh, boy. Oh, I'm caught in the rock. Water's cool and refreshing. Yes, it is. Oh, look at him go. He wants it. Come on down, boy. Come on, you can make it. Look how fast he is. All right, guards. Here he comes. Where you at? There he is. Oh, he's still across the river. He can't figure out a way across. Bro, just take the way you went last time. That worked out swimmingly. There's a pun. All right, let's see. We get close. Oh, you can cross right here. I believe in you. They don't like water. I was kind of surprised, actually, that he ran across the river the way that he did. I guess he was just that scared of the fire. All right, fine. I bet we can do this. We have health potions, right? Do we? Do we not? All right, we have no stamina, which is not good. We have a couple health potions, so we're going to let our stamina regenerate here. Just so we're at the top of our game when we go to fight this boy. Come on, then. You little baby back bitch. It's just a little bit of water. It's no problem. All right, bring it. Whoa. Bring it, then. Come on. Got him. That's what I'm talking about. All right. One wolf down. Man, what a... What a perilous kind of encounter that was. I mean, this is how it's designed. When you're level one, something as simple as a wolf can kill you, which I do appreciate, but it's not good for the heart. Because it's super stressful. Let's see. Stalk through the brush. I see it. Well, there was a deer there. Anyway, let's go ahead and try and get a couple more hunting kills in us. And let's go trick that bandit, too. He'll be fun to mess with. And there might be some more wolves we can fuck around with a little bit. Oh, am I already tired again? I didn't sleep that long. It was like 4 o'clock when I went to bed. And I woke up, what time is it now? 12:28. How's it? We didn't get a whole ton of sleep. We got some. Enough, for now. Oh, what a beautiful day it is. Look at that sun. Can't get distracted, though. By the beautiful scenery. Because they will kill us. We should also probably grab some fish. Just so we have some other meat, stuff to keep ourselves full. Oh, absolutely beautiful. The water textures are among my favorite of the retextures that are in this mod configuration. And that is a result of realistic water too. It's a really wonderful mod. Let's go ahead and jump across here. Let's do some fishing. Let's see. See any fish? There's also fishing rods and stuff that we can use to make this a little bit easier. Ha! Gotcha! But we don't have one right now, so we're just going to have to make do. Anyway, talking back about our kind of planned story for our character here. Following RK for Xeromorph's Behind the Curtain overhaul, basically, in simplest terms, the more undead we kill, the better off we'll be, because it will give us damage resistance, it'll give us quite a few other cool things. But in order to follow RK, there's a certain, there's tenets that we can't break just by being like a champion of the divines. We'll go over those in detail later, but generally speaking, if it could be described as evil, you can't really do it. That means no murdering, or your bounty can't be above a certain point. You can't steal too many things, you know, things of that nature. So we're going to get the warrior birth sign. I think it's going to suit us really well. But the thing is, this is also part of Xeromorph's overhaul, actually, is that once we've chosen our sign, we can't choose another one. So this is now permanently our sign for Hjolfrid. So hopefully it suits us well. These hunters down here doing cool hunter things. Whoa! What the heck? There's a wolf floating up in the air. Oh, okay, well, I'm gonna go back to that bandit, but I gotta see what's going on over here. I don't think that's supposed to... Oh, he's fallen! Okay. I wonder if he died. Sometimes that happens in like the Skyrim engine, is characters get caught up, like up in the air. And a lot of the time when they fall down, they don't die. Sometimes they do, but a lot of the time they don't. It's just like a weird engine limitation, I suppose. Anyway, that was cool. Let's go ahead and check out Ember Shard. So why is my stamina going down so much? Is it because I'm wearing the leather helmet? It must be, because it's still going down. I'm not wearing anything else. We're just gonna go ahead and let this stamina raise back up. Just enjoy the scenery in the meantime. Here's our Ember Shard boy. Now, chances are this bandit is much better equipped than we are. However, that's not that big of a deal because it's just him by himself. And I can take down one bandit. My skill is adequate enough. And the combat is kind of designed so that you're really... It's the combat, a huge part of my inspiration for the combat design was Dark Souls. And as you guys know, if you've played Dark Souls, one versus one, as long as you have your wits about you and you're maneuverable, you'll be fine. Even though all we have is this little bloody dagger, which is actually pretty cool. What's up, buddy? You're not gonna run off. Oh, he's only got leather armor, too. That's a bummer. Don't put your sword away. Bring it. Let's do it. Come on.
Wait, this is a surprise.
We're gonna trick him. All right, we gotta be really careful here. Oh, fuck. Okay, that's bad. Our dagger broke. Of course that would happen. Oh, God. That is not... No, I can't beat you. You're right. Not right now. Come on, then. Come on, baby. We're gonna kite him into the guards. If he's smart, he won't follow us for too long, so it's gonna be an instant... Oh, my God, that's hilarious. I can't believe that just happened. I can. We designed it so that can happen, but I didn't even think about it. See, I don't have any other weaponry, do I? Oh, I have a pickaxe. Here. Well, let's just take him down with a woodcutter's axe. How about that? I forgot I had these.
There's no escape.
Oh, yeah? Boom.
I submit.
Oh, he's submitting. Oh, yeah? All right, fine. We don't need to kill him. I'm trying to be a holy crusader here, so let's just... Oh, actually, you know what? I'm gonna kill him. I need that armor. I'm sorry, my friend. Oh, buddy. I'm so sorry. It just, you needed to end, man. It's a dog-eat-dog world out there. Oh, he did have some heavy armor pieces. That's pretty good. I'm sorry. I really, really am. Nice. Okay, let's check out the spoils of victory here. We got a steel sword. That's nice. I'm gonna favorite that boy. Let's see, iron gauntlets, I'm gonna put all this stuff on. I suppose I'll put on the leather armor and the helmet. I'm not super sure, maybe one of you guys can clear this up for me, if there's severe stamina penalties for wearing evasion gear when you're not perked for evasion. Alright, I think we're good, at least for now. Let's see, what else do I want to do? I need to drink water, it seems, so let's go ahead and do that. Also, I'm sure I'm going to be getting hungry pretty soon. We got a little bit of time left in this episode, and what I'd like to do is take down the bandits that are over yonder. So that'll get me some pretty good gear, I'm sure. But I'm definitely not going to be able to do it where I'm at right now because I don't have enough stamina. I don't have any stamina potions. I don't have anything like that. So I'm going to go ahead and take a quick jog back to Riverwood and potentially buy some stuff, maybe get some stew. I really want to make a wooden longbow. Do I have any firewood? I have an axe, though. Here's what I'll do. Take this. I'm going to chop down this tree. Let's go ahead and get some alchemical ingredients. I don't really plan on doing alchemy, just because I plan on supplementing this character's martial skills with restoration for healing. But I can sell the alchemy ingredients. So, definitely worth picking them up, I think. They don't really take that much weight, carry weight. There it is. Boom. Give me some wood. Let's go with, I'd say, 4. How about 5? 5 firewood, a little bit of kindling, maybe like 2, because that's actually kind of heavy, and then wood shavings are no problem. Okay. Let's go ahead and do this here. Let's see. Build campfire. That's not what I want to do. I want to create item. And we have the fur plate from the wolf pelt. Let's do that. And then we need hide lace from the fur plate. And then now we can make a wooden longbow. Dope. A walking stick would be nice to have. That'll help us keep our stamina up as we're walking around. And then some stone arrows would also be pretty nice. I think that's good for now. Let's go ahead and favorite those items. Also, I should probably favorite my shield, which is there. And then one longbow. Sweet. And these stone arrows. Pickaxe, sure, when I am Woodcutter's Axe. Oh, there's an elk. I mean, we can take a pot shot at it. We don't have nearly enough marksman skill to hurt it any significant degree, I don't think. There's a Nurnroot over there, though. We can go grab that. Man, just look at how fucking beautiful that is. I hope you guys are as impressed by this as I am. I love just hanging out in these wooded areas, especially. Anyway, let's take our shot. We're gonna line it up, standing up. And then right out there. I think we missed, and now he's gonna run away. Wonderful. There he goes. Whoop, he pretty much ended up in the same spot. Why not take another shot? God, can you see how much stamina I got rid of? Am I already thirsty again? Jeez. There it is. You get double hydrated. Take some of these mountain flowers. Why not? Take this. Oh, I'm not even... These fucking... It's the stone arrows. I use them so rarely. And their trajectory... You have to aim up so high. Their arc is so significant. Here, you know what? Let's see if we can stealth over there. And, get a hit in. I really like to get a two-handed weapon so I can start practicing. Because I'm not fantastic with, two-handed weapons. And if that's where our character is going to go, the more practice I can get, the better. But at least for now, I can use a shield. Listen in. Oh, he's still right there. Can't tell what direction he's facing. I think he's facing us. Oh, there he goes. He must have heard us. Oh, he's still right there. What do you think? Can we get the drop on him? We could use the extra meat, too. The venison. Ah! How do I get you? No! Oh, I'm so slow in this heavy armor. Oh, he's coming back our way. Oh. Yeah, come on. No. Oh, now I really want this kill because he's close. We have no stamp. God, managing your stamina at low levels is just absolutely impossible. Really need to make these stews. All right, let's see. Where'd he go? Listen in close. I don't see him. Oh, look at that. Ominous tower. We could also visit that tower and kill the bandits there. I don't know. Whoa. Alright, there he is. I don't know if it's the same one, but I'm going after him with my no stamina. We really need to do something about this stamina problem. I thought we'd be okay. How much gold do we have? 57. That's a little bit. Might be able to buy some stamina potions. I really don't want to waste that one perk on alchemy. It'd be nice if we were a Dunmer and we could just get that first perk in alchemy and make some easy stamina potions, but I don't think it's going to be the case. So I think we're going to have to focus on foods. That's okay. Yeah, come on. Keep coming this way. That's what I'm going to do in the next episode. Probably in between this one and the next one, I'm going to see about creating some stamina solutions, maybe some food and some... Wow. Absolutely beautiful. And I mean, on that note, really, it's about that time. So as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to go ahead and figure out a stamina solution for us for the next one. And oh, come on, boy. Stop teasing me like that. It's so cruel.